Thank you for visiting this video segment for Dr. AFib. I'm Dr. Morales. In today's video segment, we're going to be talking about symptoms of atrial fibrillation. And so this is something that a lot of people ask questions about. What does atrial fibrillation feel like? How do I know if I have atrial fibrillation? There are people out there that maybe are not have been diagnosed yet with atrial fibrillation and feel these symptoms and want to know, is this possible to have atrial fibrillation based on what I'm feeling or what a patient is feeling inside? And so let's talk about possible symptoms of atrial fibrillation. The hardest part about this is that there are many people who feel their atrial fibrillation very differently. Let's start off with the most common way in which a person feels atrial fibrillation, which is number one, is just that feeling of the heart going fast. When people get episodes of atrial fibrillation, the heart rate may suddenly go from a normal range like 60 to 80 beats to minute to 130, 140, sometimes even higher than that. So people will feel a heart racing or pounding, sometimes felt like a fish flopping or thunder pounding. It just feels like a hard, fast beat. And so that's sort of what probably is one of the most common ways that somebody feels atrial fibrillation. Another way is people feel atrial fibrillation is what is an irregular heartbeat. Irregular heartbeat means that the heartbeat is not steady. And so instead of a nice, steady heartbeat, it may go at a certain pace, skip, stutter, or just starts and stutters and doesn't go at a nice, steady pace. And that's sort of more of a flip-flopping or skipping type of feeling, which is how some people feel atrial fibrillation. That's more of a common feeling for people who have atrial fibrillation whose heart rate is not going that fast. When it's going pretty fast, more typically people feel a heart pounding, but when it's not that fast, they may feel more of a skipping feeling. And so those are some of the more of the feelings directly related to the heart rate or rhythm. But there are also more associated symptoms that may come from atrial fibrillation. One of them is chest pain. I mean, there are people when they have their heart rate going fast, they don't necessarily feel the heart pounding or going fast. They just feel the pain or throbbing in their chest from the atrial fibrillation. And in those people, there's actually can be a sign of underlying coronary artery disease if you get chest pain when you get your episodes of atrial fibrillation. And I've talked in the past that the risk factors to get atrial fibrillation are very similar to the risk factors that people get when they have coronary artery disease. So when people have chest pain with their atrial fibrillation, it's very important to get screening performed to evaluate for coronary artery disease, such as with a stress test. What are other more subtle symptoms? Another more subtle symptom would be shortness of breath. Shortness of breath happens for a lot of reasons, but when it comes to atrial fibrillation, sometimes people don't feel that heart going fast or irregular, and they just kind of feel more short of breath. And, you know, when they do their activities, they just notice that they're more easily getting shorter breath, and that can be certainly a sign of atrial fibrillation. Sometimes people don't necessarily feel short of breath. They may just feel tired, excess tiredness can also be a sign of atrial fibrillation. And then there are also people out there who absolutely feel nothing. Their heart rate can be going very fast, and you can imagine how fast it's going, 130, 150, they hardly feel anything. And there are many people out there, and those people, they tend to get found accidentally that they have atrial fibrillation. So there's a wide variety of symptoms that people feel when they have their atrial fibrillation. Maybe the heart going fast or pounding, maybe irregular, it may be chest pain, shortness of breath, fatigue, and sometimes no symptoms at all. And so this is why it's kind of hard to describe symptoms of atrial fibrillation, because people feel it very differently. So if you're having some of these symptoms and you think that you may have atrial fibrillation, please discuss with your doctor or have a referral for a cardiologist so you can get proper testing to see if your symptoms coincide with episodes of atrial fibrillation. Thank you for visiting this video segment for Dr. AFib. I'll see you next time.